In this illustration, we'll study about photoelectric effect from a metal sphere. Here we are given that a point source of light of power 3.2 milliwatt emit monochromatic light photons of energy 5 electron volt. It is saying the source is located at a distance of 0.8 meter from the center of a stationary metal sphere of work function 3 electron volt and a radius 8 into 10 to power minus 3 meter. And we are also given the efficiency of emission as 1 for every 10 to power 6 photons incident on a sphere. That gives an idea of quantum efficiency. And it is saying, assume all ejected electrons are instantly swept away. We are required to find the time after which emission will stop. Here we can see that the incident photon energy is 5 electron volt and the work function is 3 electron volt. That means the ejected electrons will have a maximum kinetic energy 2 electron volt. So when the sphere potential becomes 2 volt due to the charge on it, electrons cannot be pulled out by the incident photons. So that's what we are going to use. If we draw the situation as here, this is the source. And at a distance r, which is 0.8 meter from the source, we placed a sphere which is also very small in size, of which the radius can be taken as r, which is 8 multiplied by 10 to power minus 3 meter. So, in this situation, when the source power is p, we can see the intensity of radiation of source at the location of a sphere is p by 4 pi small r square. And we can calculate the energy incident on a sphere is, this energy can be directly given as p by 4 pi small r square multiplied by pi r square, because only through the cross-sectional area of the sphere, light energy will be incident on it. Or if this is the energy which is incident on the sphere, per second we are calculating, this will be in joule per second because we are using its power. So we can easily calculate the number of photons per second incident on a sphere. This can be calculated as n, as total energy per second falling on a sphere is E. We can give it E divided by 5 electron volt, which is the energy of one photon. So number of photons per second can be given as E by 5 electron volt. And we are given that 1 out of every 10 to the power 6 photons eject an electron. So we can also calculate the number of electrons ejected per second from a sphere. We calculate these as NE, number of electrons ejected per second. This can be given as N divided by 10 to power 6, because out of 10 to power 6 photons, 1 electron is ejected. And this will also further give us the charge on a sphere. After time t, so if this much number of electrons are ejected out per second, so this multiplied by charge of electron and multiplied by time will give us the value of charge at time t, which is NE multiplied by E multiplied by t. So we substitute the value here, you can see the charge at time t we are getting is, substituting this value is P R square E T divided by 4 small r square multiplied by 5 electron volt multiplied by 10 to power 6. So this is giving us the value of charge on this sphere as a function of time. And here we can see photoelectric emission stops from a sphere when its potential rises to 2 volt. because in this situation here we can see the maximum kinetic energy of electrons which are ejecting out from the sphere is 2 electron volt. Here we can write kinetic energy of electrons maximum which comes out is 5 electron volt minus 3 electron volt, which is the work function, that is 2 electron volt. So if due to removal of electrons from a sphere it will get positively charged and its potential becomes plus 2 volt, then the amount of additional work required to remove these electrons from the sphere will be 2 electron volts. So this kinetic energy will not be sufficient to remove electrons from the sphere, because 2 electron volt is an additional work required to be done against the electric attraction on electrons. So here we can write that the potential becomes 2 volts when 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught multiplied by q divided by r is equals to 2. This is the potential expression for a charged metal sphere. So simplifying this, or if we continue from here substituting the values, you can see this will give us 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught r multiplied by charge. We are already having p r square e t divided by 4 small r square 5 electron volt multiplied by 10 to power 6 should be equals to 2. So here one r gets cancelled out, and on substituting the values you can see the value of time we are getting is, this will be on substituting the value, this 2 multiplied by 4 multiplied by small r is 0.8. So the 0.8 whole square multiplied by 5e multiplied by 10 to power 6 whole divided by, if we substitute the value, power given as 3.2 into 10 to power minus 3 multiplied by radius is 8 into 10 to power minus 3 multiplied by e multiplied by this 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is 9 into 10 to power 9. Here this e gets cancelled out, and on simplifying these numerical values will get it 111 seconds. That is the result of this problem.